Welcome to the podcast 500 Years of Urban Farming in Denmark, Past Experiences.
But then I start to realize that urban farming was not something very new, and I could see when I start digging into the history of my own country that I could actually go 500 years back.
And future prospects.
Urban farming has popular solutions to unpopular problems. Something has to be done, and urban farming has a lot to contribute with solutions to this.
The podcast is based upon the book bearing the same title, a book written by Dr. Paul Rye Kledal, who is educated as an agricultural economist.
Yes, why did I engage in such a big project?
The podcast is packed with history and gems about urban farming, both from a Danish and a European perspective. You will hear about different types of urban farming, for instance, agrihoods, aquaponics, vertical forests, and green rooftops.
Cities are already responsible for 70% of the greenhouse gases in the world. So if you want to change, you want to do something about climate, you have to look towards the way we organize our lives, our work, our leisure in the cities. All major cities shall have an urban farm policy incorporated in the municipal plan.
Welcome to the podcast 500 Years of Urban Farming in Denmark, Past Experiences and Future Prospects. If you would like to read more, please visit paulryekledal.dk.